everybody. This is Dr. Britt Talley Daniel MD, and I'm a neurologist and headache doctor. I was thinking that now we have three new drugs that are not triptans, and these are the first new drugs for acute therapy migraine that have come out in a long time. As the first triptan came out in 1991, which was injectable Imitrex 6 milligrams subcutaneously. So I'm going to give a talk about these new drugs. Move over, triptans. There's several new drugs for acute migraine treatment available now, and they are Nurtec, which is Rimogepant, the generic, Ubrelvy, which is Ergogepant, and Reyvow, which is Lasmiditan. These are all oral drugs, and two of them work on blocking CGR metabolism, which is the inflammatory neurochemicals that are released during the migraine process, and the other one works on serotonin, which is also part of the migraine neurochemical reaction. ICER, I-C-E-R, which is the Institute for Clinical and Economic Review, has released its final evidence report and accompanying report at a glance on the clinical effectiveness and economic value of a trio, that's these three drugs I'm talking about, of recently approved acute migraine treatments, deciding that the available evidence suggests with moderate certainty that all three offer a small, are substantial net health benefit, and with a high certainty of at least a small net health benefit. So ICER clinical trial data suggests that the therapies all decrease symptoms of migraine attacks and improve function compared with placebo for those who are unable to take triptans. And ICER noted that for those who can, its indirect comparisons imply that triptans are more effective than these newly approved drugs. For patients who are unable to take triptans or who don't get adequate benefit from those more affordable options, these new migraine therapies appear to relieve migraine symptoms in 10 to 20% of patients who respond to this placebo, said Dr. David Ryan, the chief medical officer of ICER. So triptans work in about 80% of patients with migraine, still the best drug for acute therapy. There are seven triptans, two of them are nasal sprays, one of them is a shot, the rest of them are oral, and they're all generic, and insurance covers most of those. So this would be for patients, 20% of patients who don't respond to a triptan for migraine treatment. Economically, the ICER report suggested the long-term effectiveness of lasmiditan was in excess of the accepted thresholds for quality-adjusted life year, which ranges from $50,000 to $150,000. However, they thought that both sumatriptan and eliotriptan are both less expensive and more effective than the newer agents. I'm going to talk about them individually. Now, Nurtec is administered as a fast-acting, orally disintegrating, single-dose 75-milligram tablet in patients who have episodic or chronic migraine. And the study regarding that demonstrated a statistically significant reduction from baseline in monthly migraine days in individuals treated with Rimogepant or Nurtec compared with placebo. Treatment provided pain relief within 1 hour. Nurtec has a sustained efficacy of pain relief lasting as long as 48 hours for many patients. Wow, that's pretty good. Side effects were few and usually mild. The serious side effects were a hypersensitivity reaction, which is either immediately or delayed, and then milder ones, which are dyspnea, severe rash, and then nausea. Nausea is really the most common side effect. This is an unusual drug that works quickly for acute therapy. It also has been approved also recently for episodic and chronic migraine prevention. So this is really an unusual drug. You can use it for acute therapy, and you can also use it for preventive therapy of episodic and chronic migraine. You got to dose it in for chronic migraine about every other day. All right, the next drug, Ubrelvy or Ubrogepant. A recent December 2019 article in the New England Journal of Medicine found that 20% of patients who received 50 or 100 milligrams of this drug orally had freedom from headache pain at 2 hours. The FDA approved this drug for acute treatment of migraine. The side effects here were nausea, a dry mouth, and somnolence. Ubrelvy or Ubrogepant has no effect on vasoconstriction and is okay with heart or stroke condition. You remember that triptans are completely contraindicated in patients who've had out of control high blood pressure, angina, previous heart attack, stroke, or cardiovascular problems. Whereas this drug could work well for those patients. So there are 20% of patients don't respond to triptans. There are other group of patients who really doctors should not give triptans to because of pre-existing vasoconstriction events like stroke or heart disease. Reyvow, lasmiditan, is the first and only what they call it a DITAN, for the acute treatment of migraine with or without aura. It's not indicated for preventive treatment of migraine. Dosing here is three oral dose sizes exist of 50, 100 milligrams, or 200, but only one dose should be taken in 24 hours. I think that's given on a titration schedule. You start with 50, see if it works. If not the 100, then you go to 200. The most common adverse reactions here were dizziness, fatigue, paresthesia, and sedation. Now, there's important safety information regarding this drug. A single dose of Reyvow may cause significant driving impairment due to increased sleepiness lasting as long as 8 hours. Therefore, because of this possible side effect, patients are advised to not perform potentially hazardous activities requiring complete mental alertness, such as driving a motor vehicle or operating machinery, for at least 8 hours after each dose of Reyvow. Rimogepant and Ubrelvy both block CGRP activity, while lasmiditan is a serotonin 5-HT1F receptor agonist. All migraine patients who don't respond well to triptans, and that's about 20% of patients, should discuss these new drugs with a neurologist, and hopefully one of them will help. Now, please go to my website at www.drmigraine.com. And I have individual articles posted there on each one of those drugs. I just want to give you an update now that we have three new drugs. So they've all come out since about November, December 19th, and we're now dealing at April of 2020. God bless all you people with migraine. Please click subscribe down there so we can see each other again, and I'll see you again on another talk.